Hello and welcome to LVCOM series. This is the paper solution of June 2013 part 2. Now we are starting from the another problem which we have unfinished in the past lecture. Now we are going to draw an isometric view of this given problem. You can download this June 2013 paper by going to GTO's website and going to Students Corner. For starting of isometric, we need to draw. First, we need to draw a horizontal line of random measurement. Select any one point. And mark point on 30 degrees on both sides. Draw very light lines. It is totally opposite to the orthographic projections which we in which we are taking views from the isometric drawing. Over here we are having this problem. We are having these two views. From these two views we need to draw the isometric projections. Now the first thing we are starting is by drawing the line as per the given direction. We are having a total measurement of, as you can see over here, we are having total measurement of 35 plus 50, that is 85, plus 10 is 95, plus 25 is 120. So we are going to draw a line of 120 mm. This line would be dark. Now we have drawn this length. Now it's time for drawing this length. It's 20 plus 20 plus 20 is equal to 60. But here, as you can see, after 20 there is a slot given. So we are going to draw a line of just 20 mm only. Now, as you can see, isometric drawings are generally made up of various steps. Now we are going to start with this base. The total length is 120 mm and the height is 20 mm. So now we are going to put the height to this isometric view. For this, you need to use the protractor. Mark one point as perpendicular. And draw a 20 mm line. As this line where I am putting my protractor is on 30 degree. This is 30 degree, right? These are lines at 30 degree. So if we want to draw a perpendicular line, then we need to take point at 60 degree. From 60 degree again we are going to place line of 20. Now just as simple, you just need to join the line. Now we are done with this total length and this height. Now it's time to draw these slots. Again, from this point, please make sure that you are just using 60 and 90 degrees only, so that it would be very convenient. I refer that you should use set square instead of roller scale, as roller scale may slip and you can you might not get proper perpendicular lines, proper parallel lines. So that's my concern, so that's why I'm preferring to use the set square only. Now I've drawn this line. Now it's time to go inside. The inside distance is given as 25 mm. This distance is given as 25 mm, so I'm going to draw this slot. Now for that, again I need to mark point at 60 degree. From that 60 degree, I need to draw 1, 2 and 2.5, 25. Now as you can see, I've gone inside for 25 mm. Now it's time for again 20 mm. This given 20 mm, so again one line at an angle of 60 degree. Draw a slot length of 20. Again from this, mark a point on 60 degree. Come outside for 25. From this, again mark a point on 60 degree and join the line on this 30 degree line. Now we have made the slot. Now we have made this slot, but in the 3D drawing it will have some more projections also. As you can see, this kind of structure will be shown in the figure. We can see this kind of slot. Now it's very simple, you just need to go again 20 mm. It would be very parallel to the previous line only, no need to use the protractor. Now make this line darker. Now we have made this base plate, one side of base plate. Now we are going to place this one, this heighted 50 mm height, 50 mm in the width and 20 mm in the height. So we are going to place this rectangular surface. As it is in the very in the midpoint, so I am marking the midpoint and drawing this structure. Again on the 60 degree, I am doing the projections. It is highly recommend that you should use only set square, because in the roller scale the given protractor may give you some wrong dimensions, leads to the wrong problem. We are going to make the cylinder on this rectangular surface, and there are various methods of drawing cylinders. Drawn this rectangular surface and only required lines I am doing it dark, other lines would be very lighter. Going to make this square box. Of 60 mm long. As you can see that the construction is going on very smoothly. Now I have made this construction. And now I need to draw another line. This side. Again, I am using this protractor and marking the lines on 60 degree. It would be of the same size of this side. So again on the 20 mm, I am marking one line. From that 20 mm itself, I am going 20 mm inside, but as you can see that it is just colliding the inside surface. So I am just leaving it, and I am just drawing very light lines so that I don't have to erase that portions. Now again on this side also, I am drawing very light lines. As you can see that slot would be of the 20 mm deep. So I am drawing this line making, now I am making this line darker. You should be very aware while making the isometric drawing, as you might end up in mashup, as there would be so many lines and so many points which you have taken for the 60 degree angle. Now as you can see that I have completed the construction of these portions. I have completed this one, I have completed another this one. Now it's time for making a cylinder of diameter 30 and height 15. Okay, the making cylinder is very very difficult if you don't take much precautions. You need to use very light pencils. I prefer that you should use only H or 2H pencils while you are using for the engineering drawing. As the cylinder is in the perfectly middle section, so I am just marking the midpoints to locate the center of the cylinder. For making it perfectly, I am marking the points on both sides so that I can get proper center rather than using the roller scale and just having the projections. That projections might end up in the big mashup. On another side also, I am marking the points so that I can locate the center of the circle very properly. Now I have located the center of the circle, but you need to use the rectangle method for drawing the cylinder. Now as our cylinder is of 30 mm in the diameter, so we need to draw a rectangle of 30 by 30.